All right. Whew. Welcome back. Did I hit done? Let me hit done again, just in case. Today, I shall be playing Super Smash Brothers. No, I forgot about these. I have pretty much all of these. To some capacity. Yeah, that's when Super Metroid came out. Definitely someday I would like to play more of these games. Just play them on stream. Which will happen. Would anyone in for fun for now? For fun. D-Shulk. D-Xenoblade Shulk. I'm not ready. It's been a while since I've played Smash in general. So let's just give it a go, huh? Oh, I forgot to give him a certain costume. I can already feel the lag from here. For instance, I was supposed to have jumped earlier from that. I mean, I'm ready. Oh, waiting for more people. Because it's for fun. Fair enough. Can't believe I'm gonna have to fight against Shulk Xenoblade. He's just gonna see my visions and he's like, I see you. Me, I'm just Sur-Shiner. Speaking of which, Captain Falcon definitely is one of the design aspirations for my. Huh? Why is he zeros you? Dang it. I thought I was gonna shield there. Now, I'm using a wired connection, and it definitely feels better than when I played it wireless. I only played this game wireless a handful of times. It's like, yes, I was Mr. really close to the router. Ugh. Dang it. Rookie mistake. Speaking of which, I had a friend I went into a Smash tournament with. What? That's nonsense. Grab the ledge! What? I thought he would grab the ledge. Of course, items are around. Oh, I need to remember my range. Interesting. Don't lag on me. Oh! Ba-na-na-na-na. Oh, no. Come on. You're sitting duck. What? It didn't let me grab her? That's stupid. Oh, guess who sucks at Pong? Haha. Or TV color, whatever ripoff name it is. Oh, no. Oh, what? Bull. Come on. Damn. Definitely like how she looks in Smash Ultimate more. Oh, so that was Shulk. I guess. Shulk. Time to bring out my main. As for color, I don't remember what I usually use. Maybe red? Maybe red, I guess. Either way, I'm ready. Grab the summon materia. Oh yeah, Cloud's in yours. I just said that. Oh, I love this version of Star Wolf's theme. I don't think it necessarily fit too much with how you would perceive them normally. That makes me wonder why they went for this sort of mood with the theme. It's a great rendition, nonetheless. It's just, it doesn't feel like, it doesn't have the energy of antagonists. All that much. Can the real Ganondorf please stand up? Granted, this is the final month. Oh no! Dorn. What was that one move I like doing? Up tilt. I'm surprised they just didn't replace it with like a sword equivalent. Because this is still hilarious. He's got no business doing this. Oi! Get over here, stupid. Sorry, it's been a while since I've gotten to see this rendition of Ganondorf. I kind of miss him. I mean, I haven't played Smash Ultimate in a while either. I've 100%ed World of Light and gotten just about every spirit, except for the new ones that came out recently. In that special Kingdom Hearts one, because, like, why bother? I'm sure getting the game isn't the only way to get that particular spirit. I know some dude online was like, oh my god, look at how much it cost me to get this spirit. And I was like, this is DLC territory. You don't need to count this for 100% completion. Whoo! Tanked it. Oh man. Gotta love super armor. Okay, I think I'm gonna go to 4 Glory. Apparently that's where the action is happening. Ugh! Oh, speaking of which. Oh. Command grab. Ugh! Oh, I'm not making out of this one. Dang it. A reverse warlock punch? Is that what it's called? If I recall. Warlock punch. I gotta say, as a kid, that conceptually, like, warped my mind, because I was like, warlock punching? You know how raw that sounds? And how much that also doesn't make sense simultaneously? That's so cool. A wizard going out of the... It's like, I know the meme is popular even now, but like, haha, buff wizard, ooga booga. That's what Ganondorf is. Has always been. Never mind, Smash got him fighting like a... Like, look at this aerial kick. You think a grown man has any business kicking like that? Maybe Ocarina of Time Ganondorf. Pre-7-year time skip. But like, this is a grown man. This is a dude that doesn't remember what it's like to be a kid. Never mind a baby. Get over here. I gotta say, Ganondorf has one of the best command grabs in fiction. Just, let me grab your face and then explode. Oh no. I still think it's a good idea that it's not like in Melee where, oh, you can't grab the ledge because I'm on the ledge now. No, get off the ledge, stupid. People argue it's too defensive. I'd argue if a game lets you be more defensive, it's all the more important to be able to bait out attacks in neutral. You know? You gotta let people know, even if you're trying to play safe, you're never safe. If you're that good. If you're that good. If not, I don't know, just keep complaining about how not good you are about dealing with defensive mechanics. Wizard foot kind of sounds corny, though. Warlock punch will forever sound cool to me. Dude. Send help. Hey, dude. Oh, hey, Hayate, how you doing? I was just rambling about how cool it is to be... Oh, what? A wizard. Doing good, just chilling. Alright. For now, we're going to be playing Smash for Wii U. I'm just, you know, practicing before I get into 4 Glory. What? There was someone just here. I guess T.I. doesn't want to fight then. I guess he saw the name Sur-Shiner and was like, oh no. Granted, I guess because it's almost 1 o'clock where I'm at, not too many people would even be on this. Well, obviously, the simple fact that Ultimate is just overall better when it comes to just playing online. Yeah. Rat. Oh. That too, of course. Just earlier today I was talking to my friend about future stuff I'm gonna do with my Wii U in terms of like streaming and gaming and everything. And he was like, haha, yeah, you're probably the only guy I know who has a Wii U. And that guy has a Wii. I was like, fair enough. Honestly, when I first got my Switch, I only had like one game. Sorry, two games, roughly. In its early days, it was Smash Ultimate. And Toe Jam and Earl Back in the Groove when it came out. Yeah, it was Smash Ultimate for like 3 months. And then Toe Jam and Earl Back in the Groove came out. And then I bought that digitally. So it was just a Smash machine for me, but I was primarily playing it handheld because I didn't really have a TV at the time either. I wonder why I picked this stage. So, like, my Wii U was filled with virtual console games. And, of course, the exclusives that I had at the time that weren't ported to the Switch yet. Xenoblade X, The Wonderful 101. I mean, still Wonderful 101. I mean, Xenoblade X still isn't on the Wii U, but still. How many games do I have that were ported on the Wii U? I could look right over. I have Pokken Tournament. I have Wonderful 101. I just said that. I have Mario Maker 1, not 2. I got Splatoon 1, not 2. Ugh! Doesn't really count. Oh, that same here. Honestly, one of the last games I got was a digital version of Twilight Princess HD, and I have a physical copy of the original. Yeah, I pretty much went ham when just before the 3DS, Wii U, eShop both closed. I'm sending this guy to this. Okay, yeah, that's right, Mark. Quit being smart enough to dodge my attacks. What? How did I not kill him? Aw, don't tell me I lost just because I only killed him once. I mean, I didn't kill. Oh, you're dead. I hope you know you're dead, right? Yeah. You can't cancel your taunts, you know that, right? There you go. Merchant Prime or something. Oh, I have the trilogy digitally as well. I haven't even played it yet either. Which is why when I saw the remake for one, I was like, oh, I should probably get on that at some point. Well, I'm done with my main here. Time to pick the anti-Bayonetta character. So, huh. Yeah, I have mine on one, on, what would I call this? It's on top of my nightstand drawer. I mean, nightstand shelf. Kind of leaning to the left a bit. Because I did not give it enough support. All my physical Wii U games. I only have 3 consoles. Well, yeah. I mean, 2 consoles. A Wii U, a Switch. Primarily so I could play just about every generation of Nintendo games. And a Steam Deck to, you know, cover my bases. For just about most AAA modern games. So, overall, I'm set when it comes to just playing video games. Because the Wii U is pretty much my first personal console. Before that, I've been borrowing a Nintendo 64 and Sega Genesis. I say borrow. Only because it doesn't belong to me, but, you know, it's never been officially passed down. I just have them now. I just don't know where the heck my N64 went. The console itself. I literally have everything else. Controllers, games. The wires. I just don't have the actual console itself. I have no idea what happened to it the last time I moved. Oh, it's Shulk again! I'm gonna fight him one more time and then take it to... for glory. So yeah, my Wii U was more so my Nintendo catch-up machine. Because it had Virtual Console for just about everything. Though the Virtual Console wasn't as good as the Wii U's as much. Because it was still missing a lot of games. And of course I didn't have a Wii. I mean, well, I got the Wii U near the end of the Wii's channel's life cycle, so I was only able to get one game at the time, and it was not King of Fighters. It was King of Fighter 99, because I knew the Orochi Saga didn't have it, so I got King of Fighter 99, and I wish I got Polestar, but they finally put it on Sega Genesis Online for Switch. This almost sounds like Pokemon battle music. Interesting. Forgot it does that to you at a certain angle. Oh! How do you... super armor out of that? That was weird. Oh yeah. I thought I dodged. Speaking of which, I got all three of this guy's games. So, like, at some point, I should figure out how to mod my... mod my 3DS so that I could start streaming from it. I have the entire Dylan's Rolling Western trilogy on it. Oh, dang it. Now that I remember. Speaking of 3DS, I forgot that someone asked me to give them DLC data for Dragon Quest 7. Ooh! How did you not get hit by that? Oh, wait. It was his bomb. Oh, come on! I'll still kick your butt. Check this out, so. Oh no, he's out of vision of the future and whatever. Oh, come on. Is he running from me now? With what little health you've suffered, you're running from me? Okay, alright. I'm doing 4 glory after this. Yeah. I forgot that a couple people in the Dragon Quest community are trying to save data for the 3DS version of Dragon Quest 7. And I forgot that I could actually do that for them. Yeah, being able to preserve stuff is definitely helpful. Yeah, I'm sure I want to leave. Shulk is a coward. How you gonna run when you're in that much of a lead? You could have just... I don't know. Okay, I'm done. Yeah, don't blame me. Most of my friends just play PC as well. But I do like my physical copies. I can't front. Now I gotta redeem Shulk. We're done banning Shulk today. We got a future redeem shulk. Oh, that right. That's quite the range. It was just a prank, bro. Backslash. Ah, I meant to do. I did not mean to do that. I keep. There you go. This is the Monado's power. Send help. What? Throw out the horde air. Stream edge. Ah! I hit B instead of A. Okay, I'm just playing garbage today. Now that I deserve this. Okay. Ah, it's that shield attack that keeps getting me. Oh no! She got me off stage before I could.
The physical copy of the game, but over time they just take up space.
I feel you. Like, I think my Switch library has pretty much took its course.
Honestly, I was lukewarm to Ryu at first when they announced him, and then playing him, I was like, yes, I'm in my element. I'm someone who plays both fighting games and Smash equally. So I just went ballistic.
I somehow ended up looking the wrong way. Try again. That's a little too fitting. Dang it.
Ah, my controls are messed up. I'm not used to that. I was like, why am I pressing the wrong button here? I need to adjust my control scheme to how I have it in. Hey! Oh, I love that. I'm a big fan of that. What? It touched me. Get out of here. That idea is bad. Interesting. Okay, so we traded. Fair enough. Would you look towards her? That's weird. That's really off. I shouldn't be able to look the other way. He always focuses on his opponent. That's what's throwing me off. Yeah, I know I almost killed myself, but like, there's something off about this. Like, Ryu works the same in both games. He always faces his opponent when it's one-on-one. Ah, I don't get why I can't shield after that. Like, that shield bash he keeps doing, it goes like a frame or two faster than it should. With range. Like, I've been trying to do stuff like that this whole time. But... Oh, why would I do that when I could have just done this? Oh, damn it. I knew you and Bara would get up attack because it. Ooh! No. What are you, stupid? Check this out, though. Check this out, though. Good. Ooh! Oh! Why did I bother with that? They're not even that good. It just feels weird. One moment. I changed the controls. Still afraid to use freaking shield and grab because I keep messing things up. One moment. Where is it? Oh, right. I gotta go into Smash. No, I don't have to go there. Oh, where was it again? Game some more. Options? Controls, yes. For me. Okay, let's fix these up real quick. We make the left side grabs, make the right side shields. Beautiful. Alright, we're in this now. We are in this now. You wanna know my thinking for that? Link. The left side is offense of some sort. Right side is defense. I need to stop living like that. How I lived earlier. Because I used the triggers to perform the actions. What's conquest going on right now? No conquest in front. What was the previous results? Oh, this last one was like, oh, have a helper buddy nearby. I think I voted for Rosalina. Did I? Will it tell me? I have no idea what the heck they were. This was about. Anyway. I don't. Okay. For glory. That was enough warming up. Yeah, you could cap all you want. Fail to connect to partner's device. Partner's device. Is it talking about my Wii U gamepad? Don't tell me I can't play For Glory. Don't tell me Only For Fun is available now. Huh. Dang. Watch, I check on Twitter and Sakurai will be like, Wii U dies shortly. Online dies shortly. Too bad. Alright, I guess I'm doing for fun. Can I change the rules? Oh, and it's right back to him again. Run it back. I haven't shown you how it is. I'm ready to kick his butt. Energy drink in hand. Gamer mode activated. Ryu, what the heck, man? Did they nerf him in the last patch? Why is he freely able to look back and forth? He's supposed to always face his opponent. This is why I keep getting thrown off. What's up? I am mourning the loss of a competent system. But you're right. I am savage, as the kids say. Well, yeah, this month I would just be playing online Wii U like it's nothing. Just the other day I played Splatoon. I just uploaded on YouTube. Today we're going to be playing Smash. Did Shulk really leave like that at the last second? Yeah, this is gonna have to be the last time I use Ryu, though. I'm too used to his gimmick. For some reason, he can look away freely. He backdashes just fine, though.
That reminds me, does his drive impact look like his Street Fighter 4? What the heck was this called? You don't like Ultimate? Oh, I have Ultimate. I have 100% at Ultimate. I'm just here to play Wii U games for this month. Get out of my system. Okay, Ike. Alright. Shoot, I love Ultimate. Because they finally put in King K. Rool. That was like the one character missing for me back in Brawl. Whew, he almost died. The disrespect. That's it. You're not getting to me from here. Hold up. My controls are fine, right? No. What the heck? Did I just shield there? Hold on. Oh, no. I went through the trouble of editing my controls, and now I'm not even using the controls. Nah, yeah, I agree. I started off with the 3DS for like a year, and then I got this alongside one of my first games. Like, I didn't get a Wii U until 2016, but I still played the hell out of Smash when I got the chance. Thankfully, I had a 3DS since launch, so I was pretty much caught up with the meta. I was gonna let him get grabbed by that. I thought I died once. I was not paying attention. It's between Ryu, Captain Falcon, and Ganondorf. I'd say probably Ganondorf the most. And in Smash Ultimate, it's those three again. Plus King K. Rool. There's a couple other fighters that I've warmed up to in Smash Ultimate. Like, I like using Simon. Who else? Simon. I like using Bayonetta in both, but obviously because she's considered really cheap in this game, I didn't bother playing her too much because I didn't want to hear anything from a more casual fan base being all like, oh, Bayonetta's cheating! And she was overpowered to an extent. I'm not going to front, but like, you never really want to hear that when you're just trying to play a game and beat someone at it, you know? How about you? Pikachu. Alright. Uh-oh. Someone might be using Wi-Fi over here. Never played... Oh, you never played Ultimate. Huh. Yeah, overall, the changes they've made to the games, I'd say... If you're someone who plays Smash primarily for the fighting... Smash Ultimate is where it's at. It took a while for Smash Ultimate to get some of the extra modes that past Smash Brothers games has. For instance, the Home Run Contest didn't come to Smash Ultimate at launch like it did with this game.
What is this walk cycle? Looks like he has to use the bathroom and doesn't want to. Oh, Charizard reminds me. I also wanted the main Pokemon trainer, but I never really had the time. Because right after I 100%ed World of Light for Smash Brothers and played online with my usual mains, a lot more games caught my attention. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to hold the controller like this. Ooh! Play melee? Oh, I've played all Smash games. I never really got into competitive melee, but I've been using Ganondorf since melee. I just wasted that. Oh, time to end this. Ooh! Send us, if I guess. See, I'm not even paying attention. I mainly like using Mario and Ganondorf in melee. And Falco. Yeah, my favorite melee player to watch back in the day was Bizarro. I think I remember when he retired too. I was like, dang, there goes a legend. But I'd say Bizarro retired at the right time, because even then, melee lasted for maybe like 5 or 7 years after. You could start to see it getting more and more stale as time was going on. So overall, I don't blame him for just bowing out. But yeah, if there's any melee player you want to see that plays a really good melee Ganondorf, it was always Bizarro. He's a lawyer? I did not hear what he was up to these days. You know, I could probably see what the heck he's doing on Twitter, if anything. I know we all joke about esports people and all that. Like, oh, go out and get a real job if your game isn't doing this or that. But he actually went out and got a real job. Still in lava. Huh. Oh. What an annoying uptaunt he has. Where he says, I'm not interested, but he's trying to flex at the same time. That's like how cool I am. I always dig this costume though. Cloud by no means is not my favorite character of any sorts. He's not my favorite Fire Emblem character. I mean, no. He's not my favorite Final Fantasy character. He's not even my favorite Final Fantasy VII character. But he's all right. If I recall correctly, he's pretty powerful in this game. I'd say Barret, but I like using him here and there. But yeah, I did not know about that about a Bizarro. I'm gonna have to check up on him or something. Obviously, I'm not gonna be like, please come back and play Smash. So Ultimate is so cool. Now, I do like Smash Ultimate probably the most overall. Like, I don't think I don't think every game needs to be melee. I think it's fine that melee is melee. And I'm perfectly fine with jumping back into it and playing it at some point in later in the future. But overall, just being able to fight against using my favorite characters, and that they feel really good now. I kind of don't need to go back. But I don't mind going back, you know? Because I've put years into just about every game except Brawl, because I never had a Wii at the time. You see the money match between him and that other game player? What? No. I need to see that. It's on YouTube, right? Bizarro Flame Salty Sweet. Oh yeah, I forgot that Flame was the other part of his name. Which makes sense to me, because you can't just call yourself Bizarro and not expect a copyright from maybe like DC Comics or whatever. I guess it's gonna be an early episode if I can't find any action online. What was finishing touch, down B? There you go. Does he have that move in the game? Oh, I don't... There was just this one guy who called himself Shulk just playing earlier. The only other guy I saw online at the moment was... T.Y. Where y'all going? I'm trying really hard to avoid pressing B. It's like, don't you hit harder in this mode? I don't remember. Nope. Which, of course, shows just why this is dying in the first place. How much did the Wii U sell? Like 10 million? 11? By the end of everything? Either way, it's the perfect single-player console for me, at least. Whoo! Sometimes just playing a game out on streaming does bring out some people who are like, haha, you're crazy enough to be playing this right now? Let me join you. But no one right now. Almost kind of want to switch to Smash Ultimate. Bones. Okay, I thought so. So you do. Also, just get limit. Like how Joker gets Rebel Guard. To an extent. Finally. I've been trying to hit one of them with that for a while. One moment. You have a good night too, Kirby. You sound tired. Honestly, it's like most of the time when I stream, it's usually after I've been done for today with almost everything else. But I don't feel like checking out just yet. I've only been online for like 1 hour. I've only been live for 1 hour. For Glory Smash does not make sense for me. Cause, you know, one-on-one is one-on-one. There you go. Now I should have my move set. Oh yeah, I will yawn occasionally, I bet. Boy. Oh, Mega Man reminds me. I remember one of my goals for Smash Ultimate and Smash 4 was to actually get in a clip in for Styles at X2. But I never really just sat like spent like an afternoon just fighting online plenty to see if I could find one. And honestly, with what I played online here, it actually feels a little bit better than it does on Switch. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, the online for this game feels slightly better than the online for the Switch. Then again, maybe I'm fighting against people here that actually have wired connections, and most of the people I run into don't have wired connections because it's... What's the term? Because it's a portable console. Which, I don't know, is not a good enough reason to me, obviously. Ooh, my bones! I'm sorry, that animation just looks really funny to me. My Wii U gamepad vibrates whenever Mega Man runs too, so I'm not too crazy about that. It is, unfortunately. It just feels a little better. Not by much, but it does. Hopefully they, with the later updates, they fixed it up a little bit. It looked like a pacifier on him for a second there. Interesting. I can still grab you out of that. Ah, I was hoping he was gonna do the boulder thing again. Thinking about it, Kirby and Mega Man are really similar. Really? He likes going over me here for no reason. I was surprised he didn't do the boulder thing. Sorry, Stone Kirby, that's what it's called. I've been playing this series since the first game and I don't know. And I'm acting like I don't know. Oh, right. He could go under my pellets. I need to be careful about that. Grab. Oh, no. You were supposed to grab him. What the heck was that? Let me see this. Okay, yeah. Do that. There you go. Oh! Is he listening to me? Got him. No. He's just doing whatever, huh? Oh, I haven't killed you yet, have I? Well, looks like we're at 7 death now. There you go. Switch will be my last handheld console. I will begin the next Switch or anything else. Oh. Granted, like the case of the Switch 2, it's probably going to be, that again, but stronger. I wouldn't be surprised. Shiny Mewtwo. Oh yeah, this is Shiny Mewtwo. Yeah. It's like, I feel like with game consoles, there's never really going to be an end-all be-all of allness. You get what I mean? I'm not here to say, oh, you'll change your mind, but like, I completely see what you mean. Oh, right, only Lucario's hurts. God, I love that they kept that creepy laugh. Two tail swipes. Three tail swipes. Alright. Down tilt. Forward tilt. Up tilt. I love that attack. So the console becomes obsolete. You can't do much with it. Yeah. I'd argue it's the same with PCs as well. Like, you gotta upgrade every couple of years to keep up with the latest generation of stuff. But overall, PC is probably cheaper. For what my Steam Deck can do right now, it's all I really need so I could continue streaming. In terms of new games that I was able to buy because of it, I'd say Steam has already made their money back from what they lost giving the Steam Deck to me 10% off. Big fan of that move. Discombobulate the move. Yeah, I gotta say, both Ness and Mewtwo are pretty good. Now I'm getting distracted. But PC, at least you can go online and watch YouTube and do work. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Honestly, my laptop that I'm using to stream right now, one of its main purposes is for conference call videos, because I do have a side business of my own, and like right now I'm looking at my drawing tablet that I need to do more art on. For instance, I know for art tomorrow I'm not streaming because I'm gonna get the flats done for my character. Sorry, for my avatar design sheet. Sorry. Again. Can't really go into details on stream because I keep my identity and my business separate, but overall, I started business in order to fund my art so that I could someday make a graphic novel. I could easily tell you why I do business. I just can't really explain my business. It's not illegal or anything. It's just, you know, there's a reason why I call myself Sur-Shiner instead of Redacted. Yeah, I do have a side business. I don't mind talking about that part, that it exists. You know, I'm not just an disembodied voice playing video games. But also, the main reason why I even came up with a stage name and started streaming and stuff like that is to have different sort of avenues to. Can I change the rules for this? No? Alright. Oh yeah, Robin was one of the people I like using in this game too. Is so that I could work under a pen name for my art and for, you know, just having fun here and there. I'm about to block Liver King. I realized I didn't advertise that I'd be streaming, but given how barely anybody is on, I think that was a good idea. Because who's out here? Yeah, I'd imagine, for instance, your real name isn't Hayate. I'm not going to ask what your real name is. Don't worry about it. And it's not like I don't think you can't get along with people and not know their real name and what have you. But I remember this quote of someone saying, oh, would you rather be rich or famous? And I figured rich sounds good. But I also want to make an impact too. You know? And I feel like art is one of the avenues I could do as Sur-Shiner, my graphic novel. And streaming's a little fun thing on the side too. You know, it's like I've got a pretty big video game collection. I might as well use it for something. And I do use the experiences that I have in real life or the media I consume or enjoy. And it helps influence help influence the work that I put on. Like, I remember about a year ago on my Instagram, I decided to do stories where I would show literally where I got the inspiration for all my main characters from. Because I was like, nothing comes from a vacuum. We all influence each other. Stuff like that. Wow, there is no one here tonight. Yeah, exactly. I want to be rich, but not famous. Sur-Shiner is fine with being famous because of the influence and impact. The positive influence and impact that it would come with it. Redacted is perfectly fine with being rich so that they could help out, you know, their folks, their community, this, that, and the third. Have a bit of freedom so that they can have more time to play video games. What have you. You know? No, in life, we have our main quest, and we also have our side quests. I'd say streaming is definitely a side quest. But I think it could also have a bit of a positive impact. Even if it's just entertainment. Oh, my book. Oh, wait, I have fire. Oh, yeah, that also uses Elwyn. I love the white mage look for Robin here. I don't want to be famous because I don't want people to know what I'm doing with that money and stuff. Yeah, I feel like it's not their business. It's not like I'm trying to rule the world or anything. But I just want to... I would like to do my part to make the world a better place as someone who... growing up needed a lot of help. And still is relying on help here and there, but you know... just doing what they can to pay back and pay back their worth and then some. Like, I don't, it's like I'd be pretty much an open book about my money as Sur-Shiner. Like, I'm fine with living a relatively simple life, but I do know that a lot of traveling and a lot of impacting around the world is something in my future. You know, if you're gonna dream, you might as well dream big. Don't matter the age. Just about the willingness and the people around you that can help you. But yeah. The easiest basis I could say for why... I even have a stage name. It's just, I'd rather be rich than famous. But there's a lot I would like to do in terms of impact. Not just fame for the sake of fame, because, you know, who cares? Because we see what it does to people. Gives them a big head and all that. You want to be very realistic. I know my big dream will come true. Oh. I mean, that depends. Like, overall, one of the main things I want to do is make a graphic novel. And it's not, and that's not impossible. You know, pick up pick a pen and paper or a tablet, drawing tablet, and a stylus. Doodle till you can't doodle no more. Create the story you want to create. You know? I know I'm competing for people's time, but I wouldn't say there's a competition in regards to how I want to go about doing it. And I don't need to be the biggest kahuna in the world. But I feel like in order to do a big good job of what you want to do, you gotta feel like a big kahuna at least. Not because you feel you're going to be one, but more so because you're like, okay, I want to be able to do this stuff that people have garnered respect for. Not so much I want the respect, just for the sake of the respect, you know? It's like, oh, I want to save the world. No, I don't care if my story goes down in legend, you know? But realism is trying to figure out how much work it would take for you to do the things that you want to do and work backwards and figure out what you would need to do daily in order to make it, you know, before your time is done. I don't want to be all existential. I'm just saying, as someone who's almost 30, and you're just going to have to take my word for it, I look much younger. I'm still somewhat cautious about the world around me. I'm like, okay, well, it feels like I got extra time, but I probably shouldn't treat the time I have like it's extra time. Wow, there really is no one around. I'm almost 30. Oh, you're 40. Hmm. No harm in it. Yeah, at times I feel low. I start to feel it myself. It definitely starts in the knees. And I had an accident that affected my back a bit, so I occasionally just have myself stretching just to alleviate a little bit of disc pain. But I'm still relatively fit. Like, I could definitely run. But yeah, there's a lot of content creators roughly 30 to 35, I've noticed. Like Ant Dude and K-Bash, I think, are like 31 and 32 respectively. A lot of those names. They just make YouTube channels because they can. I mean, having a physically fit body isn't just what anybody needs. I'm out here in real time developing skill sets and all that. For one, I'm still definitely a beginner artist. So when I finish my ref sheet, it's not exactly going to come out beautiful or anything. But, the advice I've gotten when it comes to art, yeah, it takes time. But what I've gotten from, I think the best advice I've gotten with art is sometimes you just gotta draw all the bad art out of the way to get to the good art. So you just gotta get all the bad art out first. Now, I've had, for example, I've had the idea for my graphic novel for 13 years now. But I'd say it's just until this year is where I'm finally gonna get chapter one out, you know? I'm just too stubborn to give up is probably the best way to put it. You know, at some point, the boy's gotta get the job done. And if I feel like something's just worthwhile, I just wanna get it done. Oh yeah, I'm definitely gonna make the first couple chapters free. I don't even know if I wanna do Patreon. All I know for sure is that to get it physically and everything, I'm definitely going to self-publishing. That's the main reason why I want to get in. I've gotten into business. It's for self-publishing my own work. It's not like I don't want an editor of sorts, someone to shoot ideas off of later down the line. But you know, Sur-Shiner's vision is Sur-Shiner's vision. I have the basic outline of the entire story. I was inspired by One Piece, so the world is big, the volumes are a bit long, but I don't think I'm hitting 1,000 chapters. Oda is on something else, but that's an example. He's one of my main inspirations. Yeah, honestly, early support, I'd give a lot more credit to, and let them see more of the work. I just gotta put in the work. I think it's simple as, it's probably why I'm somewhat at peace, is like, okay, I just haven't done enough. I just gotta do more. But yeah, I haven't done exactly nothing. Despite having the idea for a long time and not putting out a chapter one. Like, I have the general outline of the entire story. I could divide it into parts. I could divide it into sagas, into arcs. Generally what's supposed to happen, but how it happens, that's what I had to write through. Now, I gotta say, obviously 13 years is gonna give you a lot more ideas. But also, I'd say the one thing that's somewhat discouraging is when you start seeing other works come up with ideas that you already had way before they started, and you're just kinda like, ooh, man, I probably should have started earlier, huh? Just no filler. Honestly, there's kinda no point. It's like, I'm definitely gonna wanna get it animated, but there's no point in filler for me. It's like, I would just do what My Hero Academia does. And just, oh, season? This up to that happens. This season, that up to this happens. And if anything else, when it comes to movies, if I ever even wanna dive into that, I would just make them all canon. It's like, oh, hey, during this and that week between these arcs, this happened as well. You know, just have fun there. But the main avenue will absolutely be graphic novels. I'm not doing no Boruto stuff where just two canons are just happening side by side and they gotta make up the weirdest fanfic. Believe me, I'm not a fan of filler either. But not, but I mean in the obviously made up story arc way. I don't mind when anime you stretch out a scene a little bit here and there, if it makes sense in the context. I don't mind a little bit of this or that. Like, like for example, another idea that Oda came up with that I really like. Well, it probably wasn't Oda who was the first ever dude to ever make this, but he does cover stories where something else is going on in the world, and it will be relevant to the plot later, potentially. Because, again, a lot of the world building I have in mind does change over time, like how Oda's does. Yeah, bump that. Now, return to your original position. Yeah, I know the feeling. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'll admit it's very shonen, but I don't want to spoil anything about power systems and anything. But there's an explanation for when even when I go with some shonen tropes here and there. Another example of what I mean by video games also inspire me is a lot of the fight scenes will incorporate stuff that you can that I've learned from fighting games or games like Smash or you know also actual martial arts. Now return to your original position. Oh, he stunned me out of it. I was gonna use the waft. Yeah, no one needs that, honestly. Oh, you just gonna fart in my face while I'm eating food? Die. Okay, I'm getting distracted. Really, no one is online. Huh. I ended up just talking about... Oh, I didn't tell you the name either. I'm calling it Limbo Star. I've already got the name, which calls it... Poor Man Copyrighted. Along with Sur-Shiner as well. One thing I'm working on before I really dive into the outline for chapter 1 is just the general logo. Cause the old one I've had for a while, I'd like to redo. Or change it drastically to something that fits the general theme of what happens near the beginning. It's the name, yeah, Limbo Star, but it has a hyphen in the middle of it. As you can probably tell, I like a lot of things with having a hyphen in it. It's the name of the planet, too. Like, for streaming later down the line, I'm definitely making emotes of the main characters in different expressions. And somewhere along the lines, when my art gets way better, I definitely want to do drawing streams. But for now, I'm just doing them in private. Bring a sketchbook wherever I go, and then once I'm home, I draw maybe like a couple hours a week. I'm trying to make it 1 hour a day. Stay consistent. Oh. Kill me, you will you. You are back. Okay. I'm sorry, I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. Distribute your weight equally between both legs. Now, return to your original position. I should probably rename the stream to "I mess around in Smash Ultimate." Wow. I talk about my future plans for this year. Oh, a bones. Let me see if Four Glory really is gone. Four Glory. Hold on, one. Speaking of BRB. I forgot I brought food with me. It's getting cold, unfortunately. So yeah, this is the online experience after midnight. Not a good idea. You'll run into a guy named after one of his favorite characters, and he won't use the favorite character, just his waifus. Okay, that's just rude of me to assume. Welcome back, Hayate. I have not run into anybody. I'm trying to remember if I said anything about Limbo Star when you left. Oh, no. No, I didn't. Okay. Oh, yeah. I just jokingly said I should probably rename this video on YouTube. I mean, when I put it on YouTube as, like, smashing discussions about this year about Limbo Star. Because that's what it just ended up happening. It's like, did he really just... It's like, people look at it years later. It's like, did he really decide this was the best way to start? It's like, yeah, whatever. What's that old saying go? The best time to plant a tree is 20 years ago, and the second best not time is right now. Maybe I'll put that in the description too. Get out of here. Hey. You know what? I should probably do some. Oh, now I get. Now I know what I should do. It's technically online to do this. Oh, dang it. I'm thinking maybe Smash Ultimate has this. Let me see, though. I'm not sure. I gotta try. What's it called? Smash? This had home run contest, didn't it? Hmm. It's the main menu. Was it in Vault? That ain't it. Solo. Oh, yep. I think you get rated on Smash Power here, so I might as well use the online to figure out where I stand here. Global Smash Power, there you go. Yeah. At least get to show this off. Let's see if I can't beat it. Even though, obviously, no one's comparing Global Smash Power. Oh, wow. I've never used it with 3-3? Only Roy out of all the... I thought I went through everybody. Oh, no. I did that in Ultimate. I didn't do this in Smash. Shoot, why not? Let's raise this Global Smash Power then. That's the goal for today. Since no one's online. Huh. Thought I did. Oh, that sucked. I really barely played this, huh? I think I messed around with the figures more. That's probably it. Ready, go! Ah. Ready, go! Good enough for me. I think I have every trophy, but that's kind of messed up where it's like, oh, ha ha, you didn't get this trophy. Ready, go! Dang it. Ready, go! That last frame where Bayonetta is just like, oh, dear. Oh, dearie, oh my. It was just me. I'm too far away. Ready, go. My range. Ready, go. I forgot you can't hold it as much as you can in Smash Ultimate. If. That was weird. That first input was definitely me. That very last one, I was like, what the heck is going on? Dead. There you go. That's actually decent. I can live with that. Let me see if it's actively going up, because I have not been paying attention and I do not feel like hitting the rewind button. 2579929. Oh, thinking about it now, I did this a lot more in Smash for for 3DS and Ultimate, but I did not bother with this. Get out of here. Grab the thing. Two five nine instead 257 So yeah, I guess. Hold up. Yes, enjoy every gulp. Gulp ASMR. Part of me misses the Twilight Princess look. Ah! I tried to charge that. It didn't hit a sweet spot. No. should be much better. If it don't have the fast forward effect, I don't want it. Part of me wishes I saved the replay for this, because what the heck was I doing to get 3,000? Not too far. Ready, go. Oh, I forgot about that. And she has that in Ultimate, too. I was like, what is this cartoony night? And I'm gonna hit up. Take it easy. Gotcha. You have a good night, alright? Hi, howdy. I don't think you're gonna miss much, I'll be honest. With how dead it is. Oh yeah, after this, I'm definitely gonna eat the food that I warmed up and forgot that I warmed up. I'm probably gonna have to reheat it. And set myself up for tomorrow so I could get more art done. You take it easy.
Ready, go.
Huh. I forget that you get a set Pikmin. Yeah, Alf. Oh, just kind of reminds me. I want to do the Pikmin series at some point. Oh, speaking of which, I think I got a recent notification from Twitter like 1 or 2 days ago about a comment I made about this particular villager. I was like, oh, I call this particular villager Chillager. And then a few days ago, someone was just all like, oh, I love using him or something. Let me see what they said. Like, it was a really old post, but someone liked it or responded to it recently. I think with an image as well. Blah, blah, blah. I sure do be not saying a lot on Twitter. Oh, right, I need to bookmark this. Oh, I already did. Good. Huh. Yeah, I guess it got buried. Or that it wasn't as recent as I thought it was.
Some are back in February, and I was like, what? This happened like 2-3 days ago. Chilliger. Ah. What the heck? Someone literally made a fan account based off of my joke. Someone is calling themselves Chilliger. So the name did catch on. That's nice. Because Twitter isn't the first time I mentioned this name either. It was back in... an entire tree. I'm instantly following this guy. Gears hands you an entire tree. I was trying to see if I could see my post that I said, haha, I call this particular villager Chilliger. Alright, anyway, sorry. I had to retweet his pinned tweet. Ready, go. Ah, I meant to do uppy. I should have done bowling ball. That is not hitting it. There you go. There's something. Baby! Just a little something. Just a little something. Not crazy. My rider is... Okay, that's random. That's hilarious. I can't believe it caught on enough for someone to go out of their way to call themselves Chilliger. Should I go back into learning FL Studio? Yes, I guess. Eternos. That's funny. It's not as funny as learning how someone was all like, oh man, I had a dream where I figured out that the next Smash Bros. Player was the Piranha Plant. I mean, Smash Bros. Character was the Piranha Plant. And this was back before the announcement of the Piranha Plant. They're like, oh man, I had a dream where Piranha Plant was the playable character. And then when the Piranha Plant was revealed, he was all like, oh man, now I got a main Piranha Plant. Well, it's not like Chilliger can main Sur-Shiner or whatever. It's not like that either. What happened to my post where I was all like, I called this particular villager Chilliger? I can't find it. Particular Chilliger. Will I see my own name? Yep. There it is.
There it is. There it is. Beautiful. Hi. He did respond to my post. Okay, when did I make this post? July of last year. July 4th. What was going on with July 4th? Dang it. Hold on. Particular. Like, the fact that I remember this name. Okay, let me see the quote tweet again. February 28th is when he made the post. That's when he responded to me. It wasn't just a few days ago. It was a bunch of days ago. Okay, and he made his Twitter account October 23rd. Okay, so I was the inspiration. I was already talking about influence and all that. I'm retweeting this. This is great. It's him. The rad lad himself. It was because of Kirby cheats Furby's thing. He's like, oh, did you have any nicknames for Smash Alts? And I actually did. That's funny. It makes me want to do better now. Go, Chilliger! Ready, go. What am I doing? Ready, go. This is for you, Chilliger! Let's go! So close. Hold on. If I do a new record, I'm saving it and sending it to Chilliger. Sorry, did it go down? What about my new record? Ready, go. Hold on. What the heck? Ready, go. Alright, bad idea. Ready, go. Wait, how much damage? I know it does more damage if you ride it. Alright, still a bad idea. He's gonna die. That's still funny. Well, looks like I found the one thing I influence in the Smash community. Oof, I don't like seeing that. Ready, go. I gotta save a replay once I beat this record. Five, four. Ready, go. Okay, he throws the turnip attack of words as well. Five, four, three, two, one. Let's go. Wait, what did I press? No, hold on. We're going back. No. As Chilliger. Dang it. Ready, go. I think it would be nice if LR A start. Who's supposed to reach it like that? You gotta crab it. I'm sorry, 2 hours. Hold on. If nothing else, I'm gonna beat this record that I just set and then save the replay. Download the replay and say and just call it Chillager in action. Okay. Maybe once it's worth showing off. That was weird. Oh man, I forgot about pocket. That is such a useful move. Ooh, that hit over 100 as well. Let's see here. What the heck was the record? 1900, right? Shoot, that's gonna... That's axing a lot. Ah! There you go. There you go. There you go. Let's go. God. There you go. Let's go. That was good. I had a good feeling about that. Oh, come on. I don't remember how I did it. I'm gonna see the replay. Ready, go. Five, four, three, two, one. That's not doing much. So if you hear that cracking, that is just my neck. And 17 ain't enough. Okay, keep that in mind. That is not reaching anything. That's pretty good. Yeah, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Why the save replay? My drink was in the way. Yep. I had to retweet it. I guess there's nothing to do online. All the more reason to mourn. I did this a lot on the 3DS version, but I have not bothered to touch it on the Wii U version. Same with that. God, I've done that a lot. It can get infuriating too, because like,
there's a point where just the Miis read you and practically frame trap you to the extent to where it feels like they're working together in unison instead of just collectively try to beat on you. You know what? I don't think I've done any events. Have I? Wow. I barely touched them. That's a stream idea for the future. Yeah, I just did all these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, just these 5, huh? I guess this is where it starts. The destroyer cometh. I thought it said destroyer comet. Huh. I think when it comes to side stuff, time I probably spent the most was trophies. I probably have them all at this point. I wouldn't be surprised. I know for sure I have them all in Smash for 3DS. I went out of my way to know that I got them all. Looks like I don't have ults. Yeah, definitely missed trophies. This is one of the main reasons why I didn't sell my copy. The other reason it being that Charles Martinet signed the box. But yeah, Hayate had a point. It does. It's like a lot of physical copies do start to add clutter, I swear. I might have to make my peace with digital to an extent. Wanna buy something you already got? Yeah, I need to go back into the shop. And Trophy Rush. I played a lot of Trophy. Got hours upon hours of Trophy Rush and Smash Run on the 3DS version. Like, I definitely wish that the... Sorry. Yep. I think I got everything except alts. Because that's all I've been really getting these days. Oh, well. These aren't alts. Huh. I should really just, on my own time, occasionally just try to see what I could do. But that'll wait after things have gone. If I recall, I was able to take pictures and then see it. I was using a lot of these for references. Okay, I just thought that was cool. I'd like to see Takamaru in Smash, but I also feel like he should get the Kid Icarus Uprising treatment of sorts. Because a lot of what he does in his game is cool, but visually, it could look cooler. Like, he's a samurai that uses ninjutsu. Like, I'm all about that. This ain't no secret, folks. I'm a wonderful 101 fan. Gotta say, 2 out of 10 ain't bad. I see the check marks next to him. I got my cable, I got my inkling. Someday, Wonder Red. Someday. And Rayman. It's What's the difference between these two? Oh, the smash ball placement. Well, this older one looks better than this one. What was I doing with the second pick? Wait, but one to red. Ah, yeah, no wonder I took both. Sunday red. If I recall, someone was clever enough to use Master Hand as red or something. Oh yeah, I was like, hell yeah, rivals. And cool villains. Get that blob out of here. Put in K-Roll. Huh. What was the theme behind this? Other than I just like these characters. Echo Fighters. When did I make this? Oh. Yeah. Okay, yeah. I made this when K-Roll was announced. Yeah, that direct. I was like, hold on. I can't see into the future. This doesn't sound right. What was this about? Oh, yeah. I just wanted to make it look like he was kicking him in the face. Anybody like this joke? ZR. Yeah, that's right. Red versus blue. Championship battle. I should have just done it in here so it looks like an actual battle. Sick. I'm a platinum games nerd. I still need to finish the Wonderful 101. I've left the playthrough like halfway finished. And then I wanted to get into theming for a month, for the months. January was where I was supposed to just wrap it up. I did not wrap it up. But definitely sometime this year, I'm definitely getting the 14101 finish. It's one of my biggest inspirations. But art is art. Different like seeing both sides of these. This is sick as heck. Though that afterburner kick has a little bit too much going on it. But it looks really sick. And of course I just have him looking like he's parrying it. Face reveal confirmed. more like if you want to know what I looked like 8 years ago, sure. Kind of. I've kept no secret that I have an afro. But the mustache is just haha Super Mario. Alright, I guess I'm done here. I did not think it would be 3 that fast. I guess home run contest got me into it near the end. I gotta say, that was a pretty shameful display of smashing online. I have to say. Like, I promise you I'm way better. Like, I'll beat level 9 computers up and down a block at least. That's my bare minimum. I mean, it's like that should be what you should expect from me. Just saying that, just letting y'all know.
What could I say? Custom moves was interesting. It's fun to mess with it. The way to unlock it absolutely sucked. It took me like how many hours to Smash Run? I don't know. It felt like the closest thing to gacha that I had to deal with back in the day. And I don't really play gacha now, thankfully. You know, the closest I got to it was Fire Emblem. Because I was interested to see how the story would go. And then I got stuck on a boss. And I was like, oh yeah, I could grind more. Or I could just stop playing and then occasionally roll a new unit. I wasn't interested so much in getting my favorite character .tm as much as I was just like, oh hey, I'd like to get as many as I can. But yeah, I'll be back in this game to get more trophies. That's one of the few things I'm definitely gonna do. On stream, I don't know. Because this month is just dedicated to all the online multiplayer games that I have for my Wii U. And that's about it. Well, yeah, have a good night. See y'all later.